What is up, Swiss Maverick here, and it's tutorial time. This is the first video of a mini-series on my channel about mission editing in ARMA 3. And the goal after all those videos is that you have a multiplayer mission template that you can use as a basic setup for all your multiplayer missions. I did get a lot of requests and questions about advanced mission editing in ARMA 2 and ARMA 3. This is something, yeah, that is not that easy to make videos about because it requires a lot of time to do research online on the BIS forums or any other ARMA 3 or ARMA 2 forums. And it's very hard, if not impossible, to make like a tutorial that explains everything. After postponing this for a long time and giving it a lot of thought, I came up with the idea to create this mini series in which I give you step-by-step instructions. And what I'm gonna do is basically in every one of those episodes I will add one new feature or one new script to the template, and once the series is complete you will have a template that you can use for all your multiplayer missions, and you will hopefully understand how advanced mission editing works, especially in multiplayer, and continue to work on your own. I'm not gonna give you too much information about the content I'm gonna be covering because I don't want to spoil the whole thing. But make sure to watch this video and stay tuned for the next episodes. But I still want to make sure that you understand what a multiplayer mission template is. Now if you expect to see a video about me creating the mission itself with a super creative story or an ultimate battle or something, I gotta disappoint you. I'm not gonna cover how to create the mission itself. If you got problems with that, I advise you to watch my editor tutorial or any other video on that subject on YouTube or get help on forums. What I'm gonna show you in this series here is the whole thing around the mission. For example, how to set up a description file, briefing notes, or a loading screen. The multiplayer mission template I create in this video series is available as a test mission from the download link in the video description below, and it will be updated with every episode as I proceed in the process. I hope it's clear for everyone now what the goal of this mini series is, and we're gonna start with episode 1. In this episode I'm gonna show you how to set up the basic or the core files of a multiplayer mission. First I'm gonna show you how you get started with creating a multiplayer mission, and then I'm gonna show you how to set up a description.exe file and an init.sqf. We're gonna finish this episode with adding a loading screen to the mission that will give the whole thing a bit more of a professional look. Alright, let's get started with creating our mission. I'm here in the game lobby. You go to play, multiplayer, and to new at the bottom. We just want to create our mission, so we leave this to LAN. We don't want to host the game yet. Hit OK. Here on the mission select screen, you leave it to Stratus because it's the only map available in the alpha. And then you hit new, double click on that, and you will end up in the editor. What we're gonna do here is just the basic start of a mission. So basically we're gonna create some characters selected as playable, and that will give us some slots in the multiplayer lobby that actually can be filled by players. The template we're gonna create in this series is, in my opinion, appropriate for like 2 to about 15 players. You can use it for 60 players if you want, but then you're probably gonna use like an entire game mode such as Insurgency or Domination. For my template here, I'm gonna create a squad with 10 players, so we're gonna have 10 slots available in the multiplayer lobby. I'm gonna use a default group here, but you can obviously customize it with whatever units you wanna use or create multiple groups, that's up to you. Before we go any further, we're just gonna save the mission. You hit save, and then you give your mission a name. I'm just gonna call mine MP template. I advise you to avoid spaces because that's gonna mess up the folder name in your multiplayer missions directory, so I just replace the spaces with a lower line there. I'm not sure what it's called in English. Once you got your name sorted out, hit OK. So even though we got those units on the map, they cannot be selected as player slots in the multiplayer lobby. I have to do some changes in the unit creation window. To open it, I double click on the unit, and then here in special I advise you to set it to none. This way your unit will spawn exactly where it's placed on the map. If you leave it to information, it's possible that the unit will spawn somewhere in a building because it's gonna spawn information related to the group leader's position. To make this unit available as a player slot in the multiplayer lobby, we have to set it to playable. And here in the description field you can write a description for your unit that will be displayed in the multiplayer lab. I'm just gonna call my squad leader 1-1 squad leader, so I know he's in squad 1-1 and he's the squad leader. I'm gonna repeat that process for all the units. I'm gonna set them to playable, special, none, and write a recognizable description in this field here. Alright, I finished this for my entire team, so I got 10 playable slots now, and I can place them wherever I want them to spawn at mission start. Now I'm gonna save the mission and preview, and we're gonna see the results of what we just did. As you can see in the multiplayer lobby, we got those 10 slots available, and we got the description for those soldiers, like 1-1 squad leader, as we typed them in the description field before. And those are the first and very basic steps of creating a multiplayer mission. In the next phase, I'm gonna create a description.ext and an init.sqf file. First of all, we're gonna have to locate our mission folder that we just saved before. So you go to your documents, ARMA 3 other profiles, your profile name, and then multiplayer missions, and you look for your mission name, so MP template in my case here. If you open that folder, you see there's just a mission.sqm file in there. This is the core file of your mission, and it consists all the information about what you've created in the editor. As you can see, it's in some sort of weird code language. If you're not used to scripting yet, this might be confusing, but it doesn't really matter at this point. In the next step, I'm going to create a description.ext file. This is one of the core files of a multiplayer mission. From here you can enable or disable all kinds of parameters. I've already a description file ready from another mission. I'm just gonna copy that in here, and you can use the one from the download link in the video description below. If I open this file now, you see here this basic stuff that I usually use in my mission. So this is already a template for myself just for this description.exe file. You get a few lines that you can modify. I replaced all the modified parts with your name, for example, your mission name and all that. So it should be easy for you to recognize what you can modify. Now let's have a look at what all those lines do. The first line is author, your name, obviously the name of the mission creator. If you modify something here, it will add your name to the loading screen of your mission. The next line, on load name, your mission name, will determine the name of your mission in the loading screen. With the load screen parameter, you can enable a picture being displayed in the loading process. And with onload mission, you can write a short mission description. I say short because the loading screen will only be displayed as long as the mission has to load. If you have a small mission file that takes like 2 seconds to load and you write 10 lines of description, no one will be able to read it. The join unassigned parameter will determine if a player gets put right into an empty slot when he joins the server. The value 0 means no, so in this case, yes, he will be assigned. And for debriefing and GPS, if it's set to 1, it means yes, so you will have the debriefing at the end of a mission and you will have the GPS enabled. The lines in the class header section and this description.exe will give some more information on the multiplayer lobby screen. This will tell a player that is trying to join your server what game type you're playing and the minimum maximum player numbers for this mission. Now this is the setup for a very basic description file that you can use in your mission. There are a whole lot of other parameters that you can set. I'm not gonna go into that any further because this would take forever. I'm gonna copy a link to a forum post on the Bohemia forums where you can see all those available parameters and how to set them up and what they do. So make sure to pay that website a visit and pick the stuff you want to use for your mission. Now we have done quite some changes, still a few things I want to show you. In addition to the information we already added to the multiplayer lobby screen, we can still do something from the editor. First of all, we can rename our mission and we can write a short description. Be advised, if you rename it here, it will be overriding the mission name in the multiplayer lobby, but it will not override the mission folder in your profile. So I'm just gonna rename it here to see the changes afterwards. We're gonna call it your name for the mission and your description for the mission description. I save it, and if I look at it in the multiplayer lobby, you see the mission name has changed and the mission description has changed as well. We're slowly coming to an end. The last part I'm going to show you in the description file is how to enable a load screen, basically a picture that will be displayed while the mission is loading. You see here the load screen line. I already prepared a picture. I'm just going to drag it in this mission folder here. If I open it, you see it's an example, your load screen here. You can basically take whatever picture you want. Let's have a quick look at the resolution. My example here is 1024 to 512. It's displayed alright. You can take a bigger picture with a higher resolution, but it doesn't really make sense because afterwards it's not going to be displayed in full screen. It's just going to be displayed on this small window as you saw it before. I advise you to keep the file size rather small, because this will just unnecessarily increase your entire mission file, and after all everyone has to download it to join the server. Once you got your picture ready, make sure to add the correct line here in the description. You need the correct picture name and also the correct file type, in this case JPEG, otherwise it's not gonna work. As the last step of the first episode of this multiplayer mission template mini-series, I'm gonna integrate a Init.sqf file. This is the second core file next to the description that you're gonna use in pretty much all of your multiplayer missions. This file is usually used to enable all kinds of additional scripts, such as respawn scripts, revive scripts, or whatever else you want to use in your mission. I'm not gonna actually use it today, I'm just gonna put in the empty file so it's ready for episode 2. Alright folks, this is it, episode 1. I hope you guys were able to understand what I tried to explain you here. As I said, step-by-step instructions, these were the very basics about how to set up your mission. We got our core files ready, we got some more information on the multiplayer lobby screen, so for people who are trying to join your server, and we got some sort of a fancy intro loading screen that will give your mission a more professional look. I don't want to spoil the content of episode 2, I'm just going to give you a hint. We're going to integrate a script that is absolutely crucial for every multiplayer mission in my opinion. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, and subscribe to my channel. I'm Swiss Maverick, and I'll catch you guys soon.